Okay, listen to this. A Rhode Island detective uses his extensive childhood contacts within the organized crime community for the cause of justice, only to realize that the line between law and crime is often blurred. Are you hooked yet? That's the premise of the book, They Always Win, by local author Anthony Parisi. He joins us this morning to tell us more about it. Good morning. Thanks for coming in this morning.
Good morning, Will. Thank you for having me.
All right, so you told me before you've been in law enforcement for how long?
Well, 24 years with the Rhode Island State Police and 8 years now as chief of the Middletown Police Department.
So you have some experience.
Just a little, yeah.
So you've met a lot of these folks who you decided maybe to write about.
Oh, yeah, up close and personal. Several of them, three of them that I outline in the book, we actually took care of as sort of a witness protection program. So, yeah, intimately involved in the care and feeding of mobsters.
So that's what got you that's what gave you the idea to write this book?
Sure, I've been working on it for 3 years, but the idea came as a result of the work I and others did in the intelligence unit of the state police investigating organized crime. So it's a fictionalized account of my experiences as a police officer.
That alone has to be an amazing job to have, and the inner workings of the mafia, the mob, and, yeah, you know, going through that and being in the state police for so many years.
Well, it certainly is. In most, you know, most books, most glimpses we get of mobsters come from the mobster's point of view almost. This book is about the police officer's point of view. So this police officer, Gino Peterson, the lead character, sort of struggles with his personal life and his professional life, and it mainly focuses on mobsters and prosecuting mobsters and how that whole fascinating system works.
Now, how much of this book is true? Well, without naming names.
I won't name names to protect the guilty, but I would say, you know, it's probably 60% of it is true based on my experiences, and 40% of it is a fictionalized account.
And how is do you go through the process? I mean, you've been in the law enforcement for years. Is this your first book?
It's my very first book, absolutely, and it's just one of those things, you know, in any profession, especially as a police officer, you sit around and talk about war stories, so
right,
to speak, and people say, you should write a book, those are interesting stories. So what I've tried to do is, over the course of 3 years, cull those stories into a cohesive novel that's entertaining and also informative. So that's the process.
It must have been a major undertaking for you. I mean, this is your first book, to actually sit down and put it on paper.
So it's certainly hard, anybody else having a personal life and a professional life, to try to get in the writing. So I would write, you know, waiting in doctor's appointments and writing at home on weekends. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, it was a long process, but a very fulfilling process. I had a lot of help with it, but it's certainly to see it out for the public to read has been gratifying.
And it's not just all mobsters. I hear that there's also a little bit of a love story involved in it, too.
Oh, sure. You can't have a book without a love interest, you know? And so you have to have a love story. And so there is one in this book. And it has to do with Gino Peterson, the lead character's superior officer, his sergeant, Michelle Urban. And so there's this personal involvement in the state police during the 80s, which would be highly unusual to begin with.
Right. And has the family given their reaction on the book? Have you given it out to family members?
Oh, we've given it to family and friends, and, you know, we always play fact or fiction. They say, Tony, is this true or is it fiction,
right,
you know?
Right.
And so we have a great deal of fun doing that, but I don't want to reveal all of it, you know?
And the book is out? Everybody can buy it?
The book is out. It's on Amazon.com and paperback and Kindle. It's available at Island Books in Middletown, Spring Street Books, oddly enough, on Spring Street in Newport, and Books on the Square on Angel Street in Providence.
Perfect. Thank you so much for coming in. Thanks for being in law enforcement for so many years. It's great to have you here this morning.
Thank you for asking me. I appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Okay, and as always, all of the information you can find on our website at WPRI.com.